Hello everyone, in this video we're going to draw a raccoon. Start by drawing a circle as a guide for the head. To draw the circle, first make two small marks to indicate the circle's length, and then on the sides make two more small marks to indicate the circle's width. Then connect the marks using curved lines to finish the shape of the circle. The circle doesn't have to be perfect, but if you're having trouble drawing it, just trace the outer edge of a coin, a bottle cap, or anything else with a circular edge. Inside the head, draw a curved horizontal line. This is a construction guide that will help you place the facial features later on. Draw a curved vertical line on top of the horizontal line for another construction guide. On the bottom half of the head, draw a small circle as a guide for the muzzle. Pay attention to the size and placement of the muzzle inside the head. The top edge of this circle should touch the horizontal guide. On top of the head, draw two small arcs as guides for the ears. Raccoons have small ears, so don't make these arcs too big. Don't place the arcs too close to the top of the head, place them closer to the sides of the head. To the right of the head, draw a big circle as a guide for the front part of the body. Use the four marks method to draw this circle too. First, make four small marks to indicate the sides of the circle, and then connect the marks using curved lines to finish the shape of the circle. This circle should be about 1.5 times the size of the head circle. To the right, draw another circle as a guide for the back portion of the body. Use the four marks method to draw this circle as well. Draw this circle about twice as big as the head circle. Don't place the body circles far apart from each other or the body will be too long. Under the front part of the body, draw an angled vertical line as a guide for the front leg. Bend the line slightly a couple of times to indicate the joints and again at the bottom for the foot. To the left, draw a shorter angled line as a guide for the other front leg. Under the circle on the right, draw another long angled line as a guide for the hind leg. To the left, draw a shorter angled line as a guide for the other hind leg. Connect the shapes in the middle using short lines to finish the guide for the torso. On the right side of the body, draw a long sloping line as a guide for the tail. And that's it for the guidelines. Now let's start on the final drawing. Inside the head, lightly sketch two small circles for the eyes. Place the eyes on top of the horizontal construction guide and on either side of the vertical guide. The eyes should be small in relation to the head. When you get the sizes and positions of the eyes right, darken the shapes. Make the sides of the shapes pointy for the corners of the eyes. The inner corners of the eyes should point down toward the muzzle. The eye on the left should be a bit smaller because the head is slightly turned. Inside each eye, off to the side, draw a tiny circle for highlights. In the middle of each eye, draw a small circle and shade it in for the pupils. Don't overlap the highlight circles as you shade the pupils. Draw a couple of curved lines around the eyes for creases. Keep these lines close to the shapes of the eyes. Shade the inside of the eyes. Use a value that's lighter than the pupils to shade the eyes. Don't overlap the tiny highlight circles as you shade. Inside the muzzle, lightly sketch a small oval for the nose. Place the nose close to the bottom edge of the muzzle. When you get the size and position of the nose right, darken the shape. Curve the left edge of the shape inward to create the nostril. Draw a circle at the bottom and shade it in for the nostrils opening. On the right side, draw another line that curves inward for the other nostril. Add a circle at the bottom and shade it in for the other nostril's opening. Darken the bottom edge of the shape and add a vertical line. Use short strokes to darken the top edge for a furry texture. Under the nose, draw a curved line for the mouth. Use a series of short strokes to draw the line for a furry texture. Don't make the mouth too wide. Below the mouth, draw a longer horizontal line for the bottom jaw. Break up the line using short strokes to create a furry texture. Follow the path of the initial small circle as you draw the line. Use the arcs on top of the head as guides to draw the ears. Darken the arcs to create the shape of the ears. Make the tips of the ears slightly thinner than the initial arcs. Inside each ear, draw a series of short strokes for the ears' furry openings. Make the strokes longer to create longer fur. Use the big circle as a guide to draw the rest of the head. Darken the top edge of the circle using short strokes to create a furry texture. Make the top of the head flatter than the initial circle. Make the head wider than the initial circle. Lightly sketch the sides of the head along the outside of the circle. When you get the shape of the head right, darken the lines. Use a series of short strokes as you darken the shape for a furry texture. The bottom part of the head should be higher than the initial circle. Use the second line from the left that's under the body as a guide to draw the front leg. First, lightly sketch the shape of the leg around the guideline. Make the leg wide at the top and then gradually make it thinner toward the bottom. At the bottom, curve the shape to the left to create the foot. When you get the shape of the leg right, darken the lines. Use a series of short strokes at the top to create a furry texture. The top of the leg should be inside the body. Curve the leg where the guideline bends to indicate the joints. On the tip of the foot, draw a few short curved lines to separate the toes. Make the tips of the toes pointy for the claws. Not all the toes will be fully visible from this angle. Use the line on the left as a guide to draw the other front leg the same way. First, lightly sketch the shape of the leg around the guideline. Curve the bottom of the shape to the left to create the foot. When you get the shape of the leg right, darken the lines. Separate the toes at the bottom using short curved lines. Make the tips of each toe pointy for the claws. Use the long angled line on the right side as a guide to draw the hind leg. Just like with the front legs, first lightly sketch the shape of the leg around the guideline. Draw the top of the hind leg wider than the top of the front leg. Make the hind foot longer than the front feet. When you get the hind leg right, darken the shape. Use short strokes to create a furry texture. The foot at the bottom should be thin. On the tip of the foot, draw long curved lines to separate the toes. The toes on the hind leg should be longer than the toes on the front legs. Not all the toes will be visible from this angle. Use the angled line to the left as a guide to draw the other hind foot. Most of this leg will be hidden behind the first hind leg, so only draw the visible foot. Sketch lightly at first and only darken the lines when you get the shape right. Draw the toes at the tip using long curved lines. Make the tips of each toe pointy for the claws. Now use the remaining shapes and lines as guides to draw the rest of the body. Darken the outer edges of the initial guides to create the shape of the body. Use short strokes as you darken the lines to create a furry texture. Don't overlap the legs as you draw the underside of the body. Make the front of the body slightly wider than the initial guides. Use the line on the right as a guide to draw the tail. First, lightly sketch the shape of the tail around the guideline. Make the shape of the tail wide. When you get the shape of the tail right, darken the lines using a series of short strokes to create a furry texture. Now erase the initial guidelines. The next few steps are sped up so that the video isn't too long. Don't worry about erasing all of the guidelines. It's okay if you leave some behind. Redraw any of the final lines that you may have accidentally erased. Now shade your drawing. First, draw the distinctive coat pattern inside the head. Draw curved shapes around the eyes that extend to the bottom part of the head. Shade the insides of the shapes using a dark value. Don't overlap the eyes as you shade. Use a dark value to shade the nose, but leave a thin strip blank at the top for a highlight. Shade the top of the head using a medium value. Shade lightly at first and gradually build up to darker values. For light values, push down very lightly on your pencil, then push down harder for darker values. Above the eyes, leave a couple of long sloping shapes blank for the white fur. As you shade, use strokes that go in the direction of the fur. Inside the head, the fur radiates outward from the nose. Leave the edges of the ears blank for the white fur. Shade the rest of the body using a medium value. Use horizontal strokes to shade the top part of the body, then gradually make them vertical farther down toward the legs. As you shade, separate each stroke a bit so that the white of the paper comes through and creates a furrier texture. On the tail, alternate between a dark and light value for the stripe pattern. Add a slightly darker value throughout the body to create some shadows. Shadows will give the figure more dimension and volume. Pick a light source as you shade so that the shadows are consistent throughout the body. Here the light source is coming from the top, so most of the shadows will be on the underside of the shapes. Draw a cast shadow at the bottom using a medium value. Shading can be time-consuming, so be patient and take breaks. Keep shading until you're happy with the result. And that's it for the raccoon. Don't forget to pause the video to draw at your own pace. Also, please visit howtodrawanimals.com, where every step of this tutorial is broken down into an individual image. That's how, and then the number 2, then drawanimals.com. If you'd like to support my channel, please consider buying my books on Amazon. I'll leave a link in the description below. And if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, a comment, and subscribe for more videos in the future. Thank you for watching, and until next time, keep drawing.